As for most of my matchups, I will be taking these two in their prime. For Anakin Skywalker, this will be during the beginning of Revenge of the Sith, around the time when he's flying his starfighter. For Darth Maul, this will be during the events of Son of Dathomir. Before this video starts, I would like to claim that despite what many may think, I thought about this matchup without a bias for Anakin. The edges and verdict I'll give in this video are what I actually think. This may be hard to believe it sometimes, but I have thought of a couple matchups where this won't be a problem. Standing around 5'8", Darth Maul is best described as a physical representation of the dark side. As a Zabrak, Maul's species were known for their physical prowess, notably their strength and pain tolerance. Said to have gone through unimaginable physical challenges, Maul started doing one-handed push-ups at the age of 3. Before he was even 10, Sidious had Maul endure the harsh climate of Mustafar for 17 days. The Zabrak went to sleep only twice. He did this while suffering from 2 broken ribs and a snapped arm. Without physical augmentation from the Force, Maul was able to shatter the lower spine of a Rodian with an elbow before the blink of an eye, and even took down a Yuuzhan Vong warrior during a prison fight on Cog Hive 7. This feat is often overshadowed by the Zabrak's fight with a Wampa. Yes, the fight is overinflated, but he managed to kill the beast with his bare hands, clawing his way to its heart before crushing it, all the while sustaining injuries. Maul's strength was such that he was able to crack the vertebrae of a guard, tear the armored skull of a Viraptil off its neck with one pull, without the use of the Force or after recovering from previous fights, and shatter the surface of a table with his fist. In the category of speed, Maul was described as being able to move faster than the eye could see, sprinting through a hail of blaster fire, and sidestepping a blaster bolt without Force augmentation. With the Force, Maul was described as easily running 5 times faster than a human could travel. Fighting so fast, Maul's strikes would be said to be seemingly coming from everywhere at once, and on one occasion, recording equipment needed to be slowed down to see him, even moving faster than a droid could perceive. Darth Maul's durability was also taken to insane levels, powering through injuries sustained by a Wampa. Pain tolerance is another trait the Zabraks are granted due to their physiology. Maul has fought through having venom shot into his eyes, and has even managed to shrug off getting shot in the arm by Pre Vizsla, to the point where he was able to disarm him with his bare hands. Darth Maul was also a master of Terrakazi, an unarmed martial art designed to combat Force users. Maul's Force sensitivity made his usage of the martial art all the more dangerous, earning praise from Darth Plagueis. Overall, Darth Maul was a physical powerhouse, having enough strength and speed to linebacker tackle General Grievous, physically stomping him before he could react, whereas Galen Merrick described himself as a vessel for the dark side of the Force. Maul was the physical representation. Standing at 6'1.5", Anakin Skywalker's physical prowess would become one of the best in his era. I would physically liken him to a muscle car. Strength, speed, constitution, and power were packed together into his build, allowing him to overpower multiple opponents. During Anakin's duel with Count Dooku aboard the Invisible Hand, the young Jedi Knight's blows were described as having the power of meteor strikes, being able to smack a durasteel table sent at him aside. Before his physical peak, he smacked a super battle droid so hard with a metal rod that he managed to disable it, and shattered the stone he and Asajj Ventress were fighting over. Anakin has contended with an assassin droid in a hand-to-hand exchange, managing to beat it down with a blaster rifle, and has even stopped a Magna Guard's punch. In the category of speed, Anakin has been able to slice missiles out of the air and even outrun both Count Dooku and Asajj Ventress at the same time. Skywalker also has been shown to evade fire from tanks and entire armies of battle droids. On one occasion, he even managed to outrun the vacuum of space while carrying Sarah Kato. Anakin's durability was such that he was unaffected by Asajj Ventress smacking him with a giant tree log and metal bar, getting punched by a mag guard, having a super tactical droid repeatedly smack him, getting hit by the tentacle of a Trident-class assault ship, and even getting hit by Count Dooku's Force Lightning, but then getting thrown into two stone columns afterwards, getting right back up.
Are you alright?
Anakin has even gone rammed through a steel bulkhead by Dirge, not suffering any real damage, something the bounty hunter even notes himself. Even after the physical beating, Anakin still didn't go down, able to perform an acrobatic after Dirge had used him as a punching bag. Anakin has also shown a high pain tolerance, resisting getting electrocuted and casually shrugging off getting shocked by Magna Guards. During his first duel with Count Dooku, Anakin would suffer the loss of his right forearm, having it replaced with a cybernetic afterwards. The arm was more durable than a normal one, and was stronger, allowing for more damage during a punch. While many viewed the arm to be vulnerable to electrical discharges, it never seemed to affect Anakin. It took a massive EMP wave that disabled Republic tanks to even briefly affect his arm. Both Anakin Skywalker and Darth Maul are physical powerhouses. Both of them are strong, fast, and powerful. Maul's Zabrak physiology gives him an advantage over the Jedi Knight. However, this is balanced out by Skywalker's greater use of physical augmentation, boosting his already equal speed and durability. But Maul's pain tolerance is insane, surviving getting cut in half by using the dark side of the Force, refusing to die. Neither Anakin or Maul have been depicted to have been able to continue fighting after the loss of an arm, although I wouldn't put it past them. The real difference is Maul's skill in Terazkazi. Anakin may be extremely proficient in hand-to-hand combat, being sometimes portrayed as an equal to Obi-Wan Kenobi, but Maul is a master of Terazkazi, and multiple other martial arts that Sidious has taught to him. However, Anakin's physical augmentation counters this with greater strength and speed. Some may argue that Maul is more durable, but Anakin's pain tolerance makes it where the only way either of them would be physically disabled is if they took a stab through the heart or a strike to the neck. Both combatants can counter what the other has and are evenly balanced out in everything else. For these reasons, I declare both Anakin Skywalker and Darth Maul equal in their physical. Darth Maul's potential in the Force would be described to rival the overall power of Mother Talzin, who proved powerful enough to fight equally against Sidious. Though physically dedicated to martial arts, Maul's power in the Force was not to be underestimated. His use of the Force allowed him to throw heavy objects at opponents and casually sending around 10 individuals flying. With the help of Savage Opress, Maul has sent an entire army flying with a Force Blast and has casually sent back an army of droids, as well as clearing the entire bridge of a Separatist warship with a Force Wave. He has even pulled a shuttle down from a cliff, although I'd argue this isn't within his normal capabilities. Saber throw was also a skill Maul's displayed, using it at least twice. Force choke became a favorite, being employed on multiple enemies, sometimes while Maul wasn't even looking at them. Maul has even used an unknown ability, similar to Vapod, drawing on Kenobi's anger after he killed Qui-Gon Jinn. His Force senses were well attuned, able to sense the arrival of a droid army before they came out of hyperspace, and Sidious moments before he entered the room. In fact, let's go over a particular moment in that fight. During Sidious's fight with Maul and Savage Opress, His former apprentice managed to pin him up against a wall and hold him there telekinetically. Yes, this deleted scene is non-canon, but the fact that it had made it past the script revision and was actually being animated speaks volumes to Maul's power and potential. Even if Sidious was holding back, which he was, pinning him up against a wall with telekinesis and forcing him to indirectly get out of the telekinetic grip is an impressive feat regardless. Anakin Skywalker was undoubtedly the most naturally powerful Force sensitive of all time, described as having twice the potential of both Yoda and Darth Sidious. His most used asset of the Force was physical augmentation, preferably boosting his strength while dueling, adding more power to each of his blows. His telekinetic pushes sent large groups of enemies flying, and he had no trouble lifting heavy objects up off the ground. The objects his typical use of force pushes sent flying range from hallways of droids to the Jedi bounty hunter Dirge. His more powerful applications sent back skiffs, pushed a downed AT-TE into a group of droids, and sent an idling tri-droid over. At his best, Anakin has manipulated a Separatist dreadnought, torn apart a giant spider droid, shattered a large dome with a force scream, and has penetrated the force wall of Count Dooku. Many think of Anakin as a blunt instrument, but he has manipulated water and the sands of Tatooine, sent large amounts of debris at Dirge, redirected a missile, and has guided a thrown lightsaber through multiple enemies. He has also developed his skills to the point where he could casually use a Jedi mind trick, and has even used Force Heal on at least one occasion. Anakin's Force Wall is commonly thought of as weak. However, this is mostly when he's been evaded, outflanked, or after he's just used the Force for an acrobatic, as he's able to take Force pushes head-on and redirect large objects sent his way. As previously mentioned in Round 1, Anakin has been shown to have knowledge in technometry, using the ability at an early age to build a podracer and protocol droid. Anakin has used this ability to manipulate two super battle droids into shooting each other, as well as maintaining his mechanical arm. Being basically born from the Force, Anakin had the gift of having strong precognition, being perfectly attuned to his surroundings. His sixth sense in the Force allowed him to save Padme's life once, preventing her assassination. Having an extremely strong sense and farsight in the Force, Anakin would be able to fight blindly in the dark as well as know when to drop out of hyperspace at least twice. Perhaps the most powerful displays weren't on the battlefield, but when his loved ones were threatened, able to sense the death of his mother and wife. Finally, Anakin was able to transcend the physical realm, becoming a Force ghost upon his redemption, achieving beyond his full potential after all. Anakin Skywalker and Darth Maul are two powerful Force sensitives that use raw power with refined skill. Both have showings of similar scale, and seem to be just as willing to use their Force powers as the other. Both Anakin and Maul are not dedicated Force users, preferring to focus on dueling. While Maul arguably focuses on his Force abilities a little more than Anakin does, the Jedi Knight's insane raw power and his own refinement makes up for it. The two are both evenly matched in their regular use of the Force, and can tend to their cybernetics should they need to, but Anakin's greater showings of his potential is nothing Maul has shown. Yes, many of these had particular circumstances, but should Maul provoke Anakin with Dune Mach or test his limits, it would only enrage the young Jedi Knight. By a close edge, Anakin Skywalker gets the advantage for his Force abilities. Darth Maul was one of the most skilled duelists of the Clone Wars era. For this matchup, we will be examining him with the Darksaber. The weapon had a thinner blade than normal, and a unique color to it. Maul's primary lightsaber form was Juyo, The seventh form of lightsaber combat, Juyo was an all-offensive form with a moveset fueled by one's emotions. The form was banned among the Jedi for this reason. Maul's strength and speed made his use of the form a weapon that would overwhelm lesser opponents. Due to the physical and mental requirements Form 7 demanded, practitioners were often required to be well-versed in multiple other forms. Maul coupled his use of Juyo with Nemon and Ataru. Nemon and Jarkai is noted by Darth Plagueis, and Ataru in Darth Maul Lockdown. Maul has repeatedly shown to use acrobatics, and his body is capable of continuously using Ataru's energetic movesets, which is more than I could say for others. As previously mentioned in Round 1, Darth Maul was a master of Terrascazi, an unarmed martial art designed to combat Force users. Darth Maul's Force sensitivity made this all the more dangerous. He would frequently integrate physical strikes into his lightsaber sequences to great effect. However, although his power in the Force had increased, and his dueling skills elevated, Maul is shown nowhere near the level of tactical ingenuity he used to. Still, Darth Maul would go on to become one of the most formidable duelists of the Clone Wars era, able to match both Mace Windu and Aayla Secura for a brief amount of time. Anakin Skywalker was undoubtedly one of the best duelists of the Clone Wars era. I'd argue that by the time of Revenge of the Sith, he was a dead equal to Mace Windu. Anakin would experiment with lightsaber dueling as he did with machines. During their final duel, Count Dooku would recognize Anakin as the finest Jimso practitioner he'd ever seen. This includes Plo Koon. The fifth form of lightsaber combat, Jimso was created alongside Ataru in answer to Sarisu's lack of offensive capability. The form was based around strength-based attacks, countering and immediately attacking with even greater force. While Anakin's primary form was the Way of the Krayt Dragon, he added multiple others into his mix. Anakin would originally state Shi Cho to be too simplistic to be effective, but he would later add it to his formula. Thousands of hours spent training and sparring with Obi-Wan Kenobi would develop his skills and familiarity with Sarisu. Anakin would also implement Ataru's footwork and physical strikes into his Jimso attack sequences, overcoming the form's lack of mobility. Although he'd use Ataru as a secondary offensive form, Anakin would make adjustments to it, overcoming the form's weakness in blast deflection. Anakin also had knowledge of Nemon, integrating force-based attacks into his movesets. His advanced study of Ataru, and at the very least proficient use of Nemon, would help his use of Jarkai, another area where Anakin is highly skilled in. While some may say he was weak while dual-wielding, being unable to take Barriss out, Anakin was holding back. He needed to prove Ahsoka innocent, so walking into the courtroom with a dead body wasn't going to cut it. It wasn't until Barriss sliced the second saber he was using apart where Anakin got serious and had finally had enough, bringing out his Jimso. Due to his cybernetic arm, Anakin would also become proficient dueling with his left hand, as seen in the beginning of the fight, visibly using Ataru left-handed. Anakin's lightsaber was built specifically for his favorite form, further increasing its effectiveness and giving him an advantage over regular ones. However, he is repeatedly shown to use other weapons, even using a blaster as a secondary. Anakin has even shown to have basic knowledge with the light whip. Yes, he was stopped. But are we really going to blame him for using a weapon that leaves openings against the Master of Makashi? In fact, that gives me an idea. Overall, Anakin Skywalker was an extremely skilled duelist. Many say his victory over Dooku was due to his inhuman strength. However, Anakin defeated the Count through a finesse move, out-fencing the best fencer of the Clone Wars era. Anakin Skywalker and Darth Maul are both accomplished duelists. Both have a style built around a form and are primarily offensive fighters, but I give the edge to Anakin. Anakin has a form advantage over Maul. due to Jim So's transitions between counters and attacks being well suited for taking advantage of the openings Juyo leaves and its lack of defense. Darth Maul may be a master of Juyo and Niman, but Anakin has Jim So and Ataru to work with. He also has knowledge of Niman as well, and has even used the Risu maneuvers in his attack sequences. Maul may be capable of launching an overwhelming Juyo offensive, but it is still subject to the defensive weaknesses of the form. Maul has also shown none of the refinement or finesse Anakin has. Maul may have created his own personalized style, but Anakin has adjusted forms to the point where their shortcomings are made up for or where they can be used in an offensive manner. If Darth Maul was fighting pre-Zoot Vader, he may have better success, but this is Anakin Skywalker who wouldn't be hindered by his rage or deprived of sleep or food for several days. Anakin Skywalker who would have the focus to penetrate Count Dooku's force wall, outfence him with superior finesse, and to gain the edge as a lightsaber duelist.
I will do what I must.
You will try.
The fight between Anakin Skywalker and Darth Maul is one I've been wanting to see for quite some time. Both are evenly matched in physicality, but Anakin gets the edge in the Force and dueling, although it's by an extremely close margin. Let's set up this fight. Let's say it takes place on the Invisible Hand. In fact, let's recreate the moment Dooku walks into the room, except this time, the two super battle droids would be flanking Darth Maul. Let's also say Palpatine will not interfere or try to provoke Anakin, wanting to test the abilities of both his former and desired future apprentice. Kenobi will also be absent. As a final tally, I place the advantage to the victor 7-10. The following is a hypothetical battle of one majority victory. Each fight would be close, but one combatant has advantages that give them the majority. Of the two, I believe Darth Maul would be the first one to attack. Both would collide like two semi-trucks, Maul with Juyo and Anakin with Jim So. Maul would try to use Hera's Kazi to predict Anakin's attacks, but he'd be matched by the Jedi Knight's precognition and millisecond perception time. Anakin would eventually gain a slight advantage, his counters being efficiently transitioned into attacks. Maul is taken aback by Anakin's strength and speed, but he'd eventually break off and send out a force push or physical strike. Anakin would be sent back, not seriously harmed, but the attack would send him back across the table, causing a slight amount of discomfort. Anakin gets back up, but Maul is all over him. The Zabrak comes into him with velocity that sends shockwaves through his body, but he manages to defend himself and eventually once again gains the upper hand. The fight would go on for several minutes, both standing equally. The two eventually end up in a blade lock. Maul employs Dune Mach, talking about how he killed Qui-Gon Jinn. Anakin pushes Maul's blade away and sends out a force blast. Maul is sent back into a transparasteel viewport, the force causing it to crack. Maul recovers as if he had just stubbed his toe, immediately getting back up and engaging Skywalker. But it is Anakin who eventually manages to gain ground, driving Maul back. Anakin presses his form advantage. Maul's use of Juyo would get him nowhere, forcing him to defend himself against the young Jedi Knight. Eventually, Anakin breaks Maul's defenses with an overhand cleave, sending his blade aside. He follows this with a physical strike before a ray of blue light separates Maul's hand from his arm. Maul instinctively counters with a headbutt, causing Anakin to counter with one of his own. Maul uppercuts at Anakin, sending shockwaves through his skull.
Good, Anakin, good! Kill him now.
Do it! Master. I shouldn't.
Do it.
Just do it!
And thus, I declare Anakin Skywalker, the chosen one of the Force, the victor. Thousands of hours spent training and sparring with Obi-Wan Kenobi would develop his skills and familiarity with Sarisu. What the fuck? Anakin would gain a slightly fuck.